Good morning, holy brothers and sisters!
Today was the 28th day of the Omer for those counting. It was the 13th of Iyar, and in the Kitzur Likutei Maharan, today's lesson will be called Wondrous Waters. This is from teaching number 78, Vayitin Oz L'Malko, may he grant power to his king, from 1 Shmuel 2:10. Holy speech, that is, words of Torah and prayer, and conversation about fear and awe of God and his service is extremely exalted and precious indeed. This is because holy speech is associated with the divine presence, which is the revelation of God's kingship and of belief in him. Holy speech is also identified with the spirit of Mashiach, with the Holy Spirit of prophecy, with the revival of the dead, and with the unification of the Holy One, blessed be he, and the divine presence. Speech is also identified with the idea of the mother of children from Psalms 113:9. This means just as a mother always accompanies her children even into filthy places and she never forgets them, similarly a person's speech always accompanies him even into filthy places and it constantly reminds him of God. In other words, even if a person has descended to an extremely low level, God forbid, wherever that may be, nevertheless through his speech he can always remind himself of God. Accordingly, wherever a person may be, if he will just fortify himself also there to at least speak some holy words of Torah or prayer or a conversation between him and his creator, or if he will converse with his Rav or his friend about fear and awe of God and his service, he can always remind himself of God, even there in those places which are very distant from God, which are called filthy places. This applies no matter where a person may have fallen, may God save us, because a person's speech does not allow him to forget God. From this, you should understand the great power of speech, and this is a wondrous and awesome piece of advice for anyone who truly desires not to completely squander his life, God forbid. Remember that we always have that special and unique ability to connect to our Creator, whoever we are and wherever we may be. Without engaging in Torah study, it is impossible to live. This is because there are times when a person burns for God, but his fervor is excessive to the point that he can be completely burned up, God forbid, by the intensity of his inordinate, passionate burning for God. Through involvement in Torah study, however, he cools the raging fire so that it burns in the proper measure, and thus he can continue to exist. Conversely, God forbid, sometimes a person burns for the desires of this physical world so much that the intensity of his raging desires could actually burn him up entirely, God forbid. But when a person studies Torah, the Torah guards him and rescues him, and it extinguishes the fire burning in him so that he can live. We see from this that life comes essentially through the Torah. So we know that Torah has that cooling power of water, both to ice those raging blazes of physical desires and the ability to refocus to proper spiritual goals. We should keep the flow directed to us from the heavens, drink from the magical and mystical foundation of the infinite wisdom and life. As always, thank you so much for learning together. And if you enjoyed this lesson, please remember to like, comment, share, and borrow. And please, God, we'll learn again tomorrow.